You're here for an eye exam and frame fitting, correct? Great. Well, would you mind if we just start with an eye exam right away?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So tell me, when was the last time you had your prescription renewed? A while? Okay. Well, I promise. We'll check both health of your eyes and your vision, and we'll pick you the best glasses. Alright, so I'm going to just jump right into it, and we'll do a little test with a flashlight. Now it's going to be a little bit bright, but nothing too uncomfortable, I hope. Mm-hmm. It's not as bad. So let's just start by following this tip of the light, please. Okay? And I'll be just tracking your reflex. Okay? Mm-hmm. Keep following it. Good. Now, if you wouldn't mind, just look into my eyes or at the tip of my nose, whichever one, and I'll just flash a little bit of light for you like that to check for sensitivity. Keep looking at me. Good. Mm-hmm. Up. Good. Okay. Can blink, of course. Just stay comfortable. No stress, yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you have any sensitivity to light usually? Sometimes. Yeah, if you have dry eye, it could be causing it as well. Well, from dry eye, there are just drops that can help you. I can prescribe you something. I actually have samples. I could give you some samples too. Deal. Good. I'm glad I could help. If you don't mind, I'll come up closer and take a look at the bottom of your eye. Mm-hmm. Blinking. Okay. Mm-hmm. Just checking for some redness, potentially. Just that state. Veins. Mm-hmm. Good. Just a bit from underneath. Mm-hmm. Yep, just staying relaxed. See? you don't mind, follow my fingers and let me know when they are out of your sight, okay? Just real quick. Okay. Let's do the vertical one. You're doing great. Yes. Feels okay too. I'll make some notes. Real quick. And I'll just do a physical exam of your eye area. Okay, and I'll make a note about dry eye, too. Dry eye. Okay. So I'm going to put on my gloves. And as I said, I'll just look around your eye. Okay, may I? And all I'm doing on your temples too. Good. Just very gentle taps here too. Okay. Bridge of your nose too here. We need to check your sinuses too. Could greatly affect your eyesight and just your overall health, as well as the way your glasses fit. Right? Everything looks very well, very good. Now we'll get to the eye chart test. Okay. Let's get my glasses. So now let's do the vision test. We'll use this chart here. Can you see it well? So I'm going to ask you to read a line for me, and if you can just follow my pen as we go along, okay? Let's do line number 3. Correct. Let's do next one. Let's do 5. Good job. Let's do one more. How about number 8? Can you see it? Okay. 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 Wonderful, you're doing great. So now I'm going to cover one of your eyes. Time and we'll do the same thing, okay? So I'll cover this eye first for you. Is this alright? Okay. So can you read line 4 for me? So now I'll be using some lenses and I'll be switching them between number 1 and 2. If you can tell me which one is sharper, but not overwhelming, you know, just a little bit sharper. Okay. And if you could do me a favor and read, look at these. Do another one here too. One. Can you see it? Okay. Two. One. Two. One. Now I have your measurements here, and I do have to say that your prescription did not change too much. I would not suggest you going for a stronger prescription at this time, since the difference is not that much. The reason is sometimes it's better to leave your eye trying to focus itself, at least exercising a little bit more to tune up to your prescription, then tune down when you have a higher prescription and your eye is just not used to it. It's not always the best, unless it's very close and it needs to happen. So what do you think? We'll just leave it at that. Okay. We'll just keep you prescription the same and give you a different pair of glasses. Okay? Alright. So I'll just make a note of that. Good glasses. Excited. first step is to measure your PD, or pupillary distance, and that's the space between your pupils. Yes, we usually measure it so we know the center of the lens, where to put it, so that when you're wearing your glasses, your frames, it doesn't give you a warped look. It doesn't make you feel dizzy, you know, like you're losing your step. That's basically where you would need to know your middle. Okay. And I use this paper measurement. Good, that's quite average. Yes, majority of people have measurements between 63 and 64. Okay? Alright. And when picking the right frame for yourself, I suggest iBuyDirect. A few frames from their website, including this one. It's nice and sophisticated. And I'm very happy with them. They have lots of choices for every face shape. And it's how you frame it that's important to get the right fit. I have a discount code for you as well if you're interested. And when we talk about face shapes, they're just suggestions depending on the shape of your face. Honestly, you don't have to follow it. If you like some pair of glasses, just make a decision, try it on. So for overall faces, we usually would recommend any shape. Easiest to fit. So wayfair, rectangular, square, round, horn, all will look great on oval faces. Now, when we go to more round faces, more round faced, more even circle, we would suggest to avoid small and round glasses and instead go for more rectangular or square ones. For square shaped faces, we have more prominent jawline that just sticks out a little bit more on the bottom. We recommend using something higher up on the nose, so a higher bridge, to visually lengthen your face. So something like rectangular or square ones would look great. Oval as well. And then heart-shaped faces, where your chin is thinner and then your heaviest is on your forehead. The widest part is your forehead. And we're trying to balance it with something. So it's often good to have the width of the glasses be just a bit wider than your forehead to balance it off a bit. Something not bottom heavy as well. More like a wayfair or a horn or also rectangular shape. Okay? And then when actually trying them on, suggestion is of your glasses, if you can fit one finger between the temple and the glasses, that's perfect fit. If it's more or less, then it's either too wide or too short. the length of the arm. It has to go all the way behind the ear. The only part that should touch your head should be right in front of your ear. And then the arm should curve directly behind your ear and not before. Okay? Of course, the bridge needs to sit snug on your nose, yeah, so that they don't come off. If you look down, don't roll into your eyes when you look up. Okay, so hope it was helpful for you. So let's try a couple of these on. Let's see. I think this one will be good. Called Notting Hill. What do you think about these so far? Yes, the coloring is very interesting, very beautiful. Indeed. It is, it's kind of a neutral tone, but it has a lot of interest to it. It's flexible arms. So it fits well around your face. This is a Wayfair shape, so it's good for almost any face shape. Yes, it has a keyhole bridge. These are very popular nowadays, very trendy. Some sophistication and glamour to your look. Great accessory. Would you like to try these on? Okay, good. Let me help you. Up. Okay. Well, they fit you. To be great width on you. How does it feel? Can try shaking your head. It feels comfortable. Okay. I do think it creates a little flair to you. Yeah. Okay. We'll consider them. Which ones? These ones you like too? Okay. These are Saint Michael. As you can tell, they are fully metal frame. I like these as well. Yes, the good thing about metal frames is that majority of times they have these adjustable nose pads, just like the ones I'm wearing too. So you can adjust the way they sit on your face, closer to your face or a little bit further away. You can adjust that. Sometimes it's very important, especially if you have, you know, a certain shape of a nose where it needs to be adjusted. Yep. These are almost like aviator shape, right? Yeah. Okay. Also a little bit flexible. And it's a full rim. This gold, off gold, I would say, color is going to fit any face skin tone. It's going to be a great accessory. You want to try it on? Yeah. And yes, these are unisex, so it fits any gender too. Let me put them on for you. Okay. one pair for you. It's not on display here. I have it hidden in this little leather case. It's very convenient. This one's called Aura in the champagne color. And open it up. Just a little unsnap thing. And there they are. Okay. So here's our pair. Voila. So these ones are also Wayfair horn shape. What I love about these ones, these are quite popular too. I like their shade. As you can tell, it's champagne color, but it's actually, it's very much of a nude tone. Usually that means that it's going to be perfect against any skin tone. Mm-hmm. And any skin color. So it's a very neutral pair. They're also quite lightweight on your face. Not going to weigh it down. Very beautiful design, very satisfying shape. Mm-hmm. Yes, it has UV coating and anti-scratch coating. You want to try them on? Okay. Also has a keyhole nose. They do look wonderful. You know, it looks like they're there, but at the same time, they don't take away the beauty. They don't make necessarily a huge statement. They're more here to highlight your features instead of overshadowing them, you know? What do you think? Like them too? Good. You want to get these ones. Okay. So, if you wish, I can start the prescription. Okay. Yep, I'll put them here for you so that nobody else. And I'll start working on the prescription immediately. Okay? So I think that's it. How was your experience today? Good. I'm glad. Glad I could help. You're welcome to stop by anytime, whenever you need a new pair of glasses.